Imagine soaring through the skies with the freedom of a bird, all while piloting an aircraft that doesn't require a traditional pilot's license. But wait, don't you need one to fly? In today's video, we'll dive into the world of ultralight aircraft, flying machines that offer an unparalleled sense of adventure and accessibility. Before we get started, make sure you like this video and are subscribed to Epic Flight Academy so you don't miss out on more exciting and insightful aviation content. We're cleared for takeoff. An ultralight aircraft is a lightweight, small, and typically single-seat airplane designed for recreational flying. People like these aircraft for their affordability, ease of use, and the fact that many models do not require a pilot license. However, in the United States, ultralight aircraft must meet specific FAA regulations.
My name is Ray Altmann, and I'm the Chief Flight Instructor at Epic Flight Academy. An ultralight aircraft is an aircraft that generally is under 254 pounds and has 1 to 2 seats, and has a max fuel capacity of about 5 gallons.
There are 4 main types of ultralight aircraft: single and double seat ultralight aircraft, amphibious ultralights, gliders and motorized ultralights, and experimental and microlight aviation. Let's break them down. Single seat models are the most common and typically don't require a pilot's license. On the other hand, if you're looking to fly with a passenger or instructor, 2-seater ultralights fall under the light sport aircraft category, which comes with stricter weight limitations and in some cases may require at least a sport pilot certificate to fly. They also tend to have more advanced features and capabilities compared to basic ultralight designs. In short, single-seaters offer more freedom with fewer restrictions, while 2-seaters open the door to shared flying experiences. Amphibious ultralights bring the best of both worlds, taking off and landing on both water and land. But despite their versatility, they make up less than 5% of ultralight sales. Why? The added weight from the floats can push them beyond ultralight classification limits. This added weight may push the aircraft beyond ultralight classification, so pilots must be mindful of regulations before taking to the skies, or the water. Gliders and motorized ultralights may look similar, but they offer completely different flying experiences. Gliders rely solely on air currents, meaning pilots must master thermals and wind patterns to stay airborne. This requires some serious skill. On the other hand, motorized ultralights come equipped with small engines and propellers, making them easier to control and perfect for beginners looking for longer flight times. Whether you prefer the challenge of soaring with no power or the reliability of an engine, there's an ultralight that's perfect for you. Experimental and microlight aircraft take aviation to the next level, offering unique opportunities for pilots and innovators. Experimental ultralights allow for customization and testing of new technologies without the need for airworthiness certification. Meanwhile, microlight aviation covers a range of small, lightweight aircraft, from fixed wing to flex wing, and even autogyros. Evolving from hang gliders, these aircraft follow specific regulations set by civil aviation authorities. Ultralight aircraft efficiently pack the essential features into the cockpit to keep pilots in control and flying safely. Wings come in fixed wing, flexible wing, or autogyro designs, while lightweight gas or electric engines power the propeller. Landing gear varies based on terrain: trike wheels for land, floats for water, or skis for snow. Many ultralights also include a ballistic parachute for added safety. Tires and brakes ensure smooth takeoffs and landings, while the control system, made up of a control bar or stick, rudder pedals, and sometimes ailerons, helps maintain stability and maneuverability. Every ultralight's performance comes down to smart design, balancing weight, aerodynamics, and efficiency. Depending on whether you buy new, used, or build from a kit, the cost of an ultralight aircraft can vary. In general, the cheapest ultralight aircraft to buy can be anywhere between $5,000 to $15,000 for basic or used models. A DIY or home-built ultralight kit can be between $8,000 to $30,000 depending on the complexity of the aircraft. There is a lot to consider with these kits, such as wing design, ensuring they meet FAA regulations, and the overall safety of the aircraft. For the best ultralight aircraft for a beginner, you could spend anywhere between $25,000 to $60,000 for newer and more advanced models. Remember, costs can vary between brands, the condition of the aircraft itself, the features that are available, and the materials used. If you are interested in pursuing your own ultralight aircraft, be sure to do your own research. Here are some key factors to consider before making a decision on an ultralight aircraft. Choose a reputable manufacturer. Brands like Aerolite, Quicksilver, and Comco Icarus are well known for quality. Next, think about features like range, fuel efficiency, and overall design. Since maintenance records aren't required, be sure to thoroughly inspect any used aircraft. It's also crucial to verify that the model meets FAA ultralight regulations, as some so-called ultralights may actually fall under the light sport category, which requires additional certification. Setting a budget is essential, as you could be spending anywhere from $5,000 to $60,000 on an ultralight aircraft. When it comes to parts, always buy from certified dealers to ensure safety and reliability. Ultralight aircraft regulations are found under FAA Part 103. Only single-seat ultralights are allowed under Part 103. The FAA does not require registration or an airworthiness certificate. Flying at night is prohibited unless the ultralight is properly equipped with lights. Flight is allowed in Class G airspace. However, to fly in Class B, C, D, and E, pilots must be cleared by air traffic control. In the United States, a pilot license is not required for single-seat ultralight aircraft that meet FAA Part 103 rules. However, if your aircraft exceeds these limits, you may need ultralight aircraft training or an LSA certification. For example, the FAA has different regulations for two-seaters, heavier planes, or faster models. With such a small aircraft flying in the skies, it does make you think, how safe are ultralight aircraft? Ultralight aircraft can be just as safe as any small plane with proper maintenance and training. Modern designs focus on safety, often including features like parachutes. While the FAA doesn't require pilot certification, training is highly recommended to reduce crash risks. Most ultralight accidents stem from pilot error or mechanical failure, which is why regular inspections, tire checks, and brake system maintenance are essential. While FAA Part 103 does not require registration for single-seat ultralights, local regulations may vary. Checking with your flight standards district office is recommended. Ultralights cannot fly over congested areas, and some states, like Florida, have additional landing requirements. While lessons aren't mandatory, proper training greatly improves safety and handling skills. Several organizations support ultralight aviation through advocacy, education, and training. The United States Ultralight Association focuses on education and safety, while the Ultralight and Sports Pilots of America is a nonprofit club for recreational pilots. The Experimental Aviation Association also provides valuable training resources. Ultralights have also appeared in films, such as the Cosmos Phase 2 and Fly Away Home, which helped spark interest in these lightweight aircraft. Whether you're looking to buy, build, or train, understanding FAA regulations, pricing, and safety measures is key. Ultralight aviation offers an exciting and accessible way to experience the thrill of flight. We hope you enjoyed this video on everything you need to know about ultralight aircraft. For more insightful and informative aviation content, like this video and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy so you don't miss out on more aviation content coming your way.